advocate for, but I want to realize the fact that this $5.4 billion that's been spent six times now, I think, and we're only in the second hearing, but that that money is distributed equitably upstate, downstate, or regionally.
The Senate Finance Chairman told us this was going to happen. There are 11 budget hearings to go and lots of ideas from you. Welcome to Your Voice. I'm Julia Locandine. How are you, Senator?
Well, very well.
So, two hearings last week, transportation as well as environment and agriculture.
Correct. We should have had one before that, localities, including the mayors that come in, but as a practical, we had that snowstorm, or almost snowstorm, that everybody got panicked about, and we canceled that. So now we got the first two done, and we're going to continue this week.
And so two hearings, 15 hours. In transportation, the questionnaire that you filled out about infrastructure, why don't you tell us what the findings were, because you got the final numbers back.
Yeah, it was very encouraging because it's, to me, common sense, and they agree with the approach I've been taking during these hearings. That's namely 65% of the people think the money should be used for infrastructure and roads and bridges and things that haven't been taken care of like they should. And, you know, but the governor's got all kinds of little programs that he's trying to use the money for. And we got to convince him through this process that it should be done for roads and bridges. And he, in his budget, he's got a $1.25 billion for the Thruway Authority, or 1.2, I'm not sure, but for the Thruway Authority, and he bills it as making sure this year we can keep tolls from going up. Now, that's exactly what we should not be using money for. Money to keep tolls down where we won't have the money once it's spent. It's a one-shot opportunity from those lawsuit settlements. So that being the case, he's just kicking the Thruway issue, the deficit they have, down the road. And I could easily see some of that infrastructure money being used for the Tappan Zee Bridge. I can. But as I said at the outset of this hearing and what was just shown, it's got to be equitable. You can't just say a billion here for downstate, billion, this amount of money for the MTA, which is the Metropolitan Transportation Authority, which does all the bridges and the subways downstate. That's fine, but it's got to be equitably divided for that purpose. So the fight is going to continue.
So we have clips of a lot of the things that you just talked about. Let's start with a project of interest to you and our viewers, and that's the I-81 Viaduct Development. You asked DOT Commissioner Joan McDonald to give you the latest details.
It's an interstate, 81, going through the center of the city. And the question is how that's going to be redone, because it's either got to come down or be fixed. And it's a huge, huge issue. So when is your next report coming out that I thought was supposed to be January of 2015? That would outline the final list of possibilities and which you'll investigate further?
It will be done this quarter, first quarter of 2015. There were some issues we've had to work through with Federal Highway on the connectivity side.
This quarter, didn't you one time say January, or am I dreaming?
I don't know if I said January at one point. Maybe
right.
I did.
In any event, whenever it comes out, the process from there is that the final recommendations that you have, or the final conclusions you have, there'll be much more in-depth study as to the feasibility of each and what's the recommended one.
All right. Correct.
You mentioned you had some issues with the federal people. How much have since you got to get money from the feds, because we probably won't have a big bank settlement for some time now.
We need that big bank settlement in 2017 to start construction.
Okay, but if we don't get it, you need substantial federal money.
We do.
Okay, have you been dealing with the federal legislators that represent the area that this goes over?
I've had conversations with the new congressman, Congressman Katko. We've had discussions and meetings with Senator Schumer on the project. You know, Senator, or excuse me, Congressman Hannon is on the T&I committee. We have not talked specifically about this project of late, but he has been a strong advocate and a good partner.
So it seems like you expected more of an update.
Yeah, you know, and there's some background here that I didn't really go into, but I've been pushing for a compromise to keep the interstate thruway going. Some people want the viaduct down because it's ugly. But there's more than ugly that goes into decisions as to where roads should be. And I'm concerned about the north-south traffic and that there's a thoroughfare. So if you want to knock it down, have all the traffic coming from the south enter into the city, a boulevard concept, then there's got to be an alternate for the interstate highway. People don't want to, if they're driving from Pennsylvania to Canada, they don't want to go through the city of Syracuse and be affected by the traffic. So I've called for, in addition to the boulevard, if that's what they want to do, a 1.2-mile tunnel underneath. A lot of cities have that. And we don't know the cost. In this, their first iteration of their reports, they outlawed or overruled all tunnels, no matter what, you know, and that seemed a little short-sighted. So now that this tunnel concept with the boulevard is gaining some traction, I've been writing her to see when this report's going to be out. Is that going to be part of it? And there's been not the best responsiveness. And I'm just trying to get this done the right way. We're going to live with it, or I won't live with it. Everybody else will live with it that's a lot younger than me for 50, 60, 70 years. So that's why it's a big issue.
You have encouraged the public to get involved in this decision. You have a survey on your website, defrancisco.nysenate.gov. Well, the findings of the survey.
Right, and a substantial majority said there's got to be an interstate connection rather than dumping all the cars into the city of Syracuse. So we'll see what develops. And we've got a new congressman now, John Cacco, and he's very interested as well. That's why I asked that other question.
So another infrastructure undertaking to replace the Tappan Zee Bridge, as you mentioned. The governor has proposed to do a big investment to keep toll costs down. But since the Thruway is building it, you asked the acting executive director of the Thruway Authority where the financial plan is.
We don't want to get too specific about a tolling plan until we know all the possible financing sources, until we had nailed down the federal piece, the EFC piece that I think we all know about, and then the settlement funds, which kind of thankfully was manna from heaven, which a piece of that could be invested in this very important infrastructure project. I think as all of those pieces fall into place, we'll be able to come forward with a financial plan that I think will make sense to everybody.
Well, somehow I think you as budget director, if I came in and said part of the Senate budget should be a plan to build a new section to the LOB, I got a feeling you'd say, how are you going to finance it before you said yes? Is that fair to say?
It might cross my mind.
All right, so now let me see if this might cross your mind as well. So now we're well into the project. It would seem to me that now you're chairman of the Thruway Authority, at least acting chairman, it would be a perfect time to try to say, as of this point, this is how we're going to finance it.
So Governor Cuomo said that he was going to come up with a committee that would come up with a financing plan. Has that happened?
Well, the then Thruway Authority chair, executive director, Tom Madison testified last year, same hearings. And he said, well, we don't have that. Nobody's been named to that commission yet. It's going up. And you saw the answer of Robert Megna, who used to be the chairman of the, who used to be the budget director. You know, nobody decides to go forward with something, if they're acting responsibly, without knowing how they're going to pay for it. And still, a year later. Now, obviously, things can change, but you should have some plan. And if you get manna from heaven, some money from a lawsuit, then you maybe don't have to finance as much. Then you alter the financing plan because of good news, or it could be bad news. So I just, it's outrageous that there's no financing plan yet.
Moving on to mass transit, there's a huge disparity between upstate and downstate capital operating funds in the governor's budget proposal. Upstate transit systems, which include Syracuse, Albany, and Utica, gets $187 million. However, there's no additional funding for operating or capital. And now compare that to downstate suburban transit systems being allocated $290.4 million for operating and $17 million for capital. So in this next clip, you explain to DOT Commissioner McDonald what's at stake if this isn't addressed fairly.
What's needed, and we tried to do it last year, is a new formula. Because the formula isn't driving what it used to drive to upstate, and they're getting deeper and deeper and deeper in the hole. I know, the only one I know clearly about is Central in Syracuse. They're going to start cutting routes, and we're going to hear that. That's a preview to the upstate transit making their presentation a little while. So I just wanted to bring it out on the table, and if you enter into or ask your opinion or getting involved, the key is another formula so that each year we don't go deeper and deeper in the hole. I don't deny downstate what their needs, but zero is not good when there's increases downstate.
And as I said in response to Assemblyman Brennan, and I'll reiterate, a 1970s formula doesn't work in 2015, and we do have to address it.
And if you could come up with one, that would be terrific.
I will do my best.
So she said she'd be happy to continue the conversation about a new formula, but she does live within the 2% cap.
No, I understand that, but if there's a 2% cap, it shouldn't be 4% increase for downstate and zero to make the 2% upstate. Mm-hmm. Clearly, the costs are much higher in the Metropolitan Transportation Authority than Central and the other regional transportation authority, but there you can't just ignore their needs, and that's what's happening so far. And I think it's up to us in the Senate to try to help negotiate a better deal for upstate.
This week, right after this program, you start a budget hearing. You have four budget hearings this week. Today is health and Medicaid, Tuesday, education, Wednesday, human services, Thursday, housing, and the public hearings on the budget are available on Channel 83. We'll stream live on the internet. If you log on to defrancisco.nysenate.gov, you now have a page there that is dedicated to the hearings, making it really easy to get the desired information.
Right, and so there's two big ones this week. Today we've got the Health Committee and concluding Medicaid and the like. Tomorrow, education. Those are the two biggest spending items in the budget. We got them back to back. There's a ton of speakers. You no doubt it's difficult for anybody to sit through all of the speakers on all of the issues. However, that place online, you can go ahead and try to find what you're looking for, and hopefully you can get the information firsthand.
And we should also remind our viewers to let their voice be heard, because it does matter. If you have an idea for a law or an opinion you would like to share with the senator as the budget process plays out, defrancisco.nysenate.gov.
Correct.
So thank you for your time, and good luck this week at the hearings.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator John DeFrancisco. For additional information on the budget, defrancisco.nysenate.gov.